Welcome, friends. Good afternoon and wish you a very happy Independence Day. Today, this is my first webinar on in English. Today's topic is how to increase tomato production by 40%. Little introduction about myself. My name is Samir Alawadi. I have done BE Chemical Engineering and postgraduate diploma in business management. I have 22 years of experience in the field of agriculture as a consultant. Currently, I am a technical director of Utkarsh Agrochem Private Limited. In this company, we have provided a consultancy for various crops like banana, papaya, mango, pomegranate, sugarcane, chiku, guava, vegetables, organic farming, etc. I have been visiting faculty at IIM Jammu and EDI. At Utkarsh, we manufacture more than 100 non-poisonous products that are used for agriculture, hydroponics, aquarium plants, etc. To know more details, you can log into www.utkarshagro.com. I also own another company that is called Trees Valley Technologies LLP, where I am partner, and where we plant, nurture, supply big trees and do landscaping. Both our companies are headquartered in Surat. Now, everything about tomato. There are two types of tomato. Determinate tomato are varieties that grow to a fixed mature size and they ripen all the fruits in a very short period of time, usually in 2 weeks. So that is a one-time harvesting kind of variety. Once this first flush of fruit has ripened, the plant will begin to diminish in vigor and will set little to no new fruit. So a single flush only comes and it is the harvesting happens in 15 days time. But normally indeterminate tomatoes are grown. Determinate tomatoes, they hit their mature height and set all their fruit at once. Indeterminate tomato varieties are vining plants that continue to extend in length throughout the growing season. That is why you will see sometimes seem referred to as vining tomatoes. Normally, the commercial varieties that are grown in the market, they are mostly indeterminate tomatoes. Climate required for tomato farming. Tomato is actually a warm season crop. The best quality fruit color and is obtained at a temperature range of 21 to 24 degrees centigrade. Optimum temperature for fruit setting is 15 to 20 degrees centigrade. That is ideal. A temperature above 32 degrees centigrade adversely affects the fruit setting and development. The plant cannot withstand a frost and high humidity, and it requires low to medium rainfall. When the fruit setting starts, at that time, bright sunshine is required to help to develop a dark red colored fruit. Temperature below 10 degrees centigrade usually adversely affects plant tissue, thereby slowing down the physiological activity. So in summary, various temperature required for tomato cultivation. For seed germination, minimum 11 degree, suitable is 16 to 29 and maximum is 34 degree. Seedling, for seedling growth, minimum temperature required is 18 degrees centigrade, suitable is 21 to 24, maximum is 32. For fruit set, the day temperature should be minimum should be 10 and suitable is 15 to 17, maximum is 30. Night temperature minimum should be 18, suitable is 20 to 24 and maximum is 30. For red color development, minimum temperature is 10 degrees centigrade, suitable is 20 to 24 and maximum is 30. So you can see that the best ideal temperature which is suitable is from 16 to 29 degrees centigrade. So you need to see that what climate is in your area and accordingly only you need to select whether you should go for a tomato cultivation or not. Soil condition. Tomatoes can be grown on a wide range of soil from sandy to heavy soil. However, well-drained sandy or red loam soil which is rich in organic matter with a pH range of 6 to 7 are considered as ideal. Tomatoes are very sensitive to various fungus or pathogens that are present in the soil. So it is necessary to control various pathogens like Phytophthora, Pythium, Archaean, etc. This is usually done by soil solarization, where during the high temperature, the plowing is done and the soil is kept there. Or certain types of disinfectants like methyl bromide, formalin, or silver H2O2, hydrogen peroxide is also used. Our company, Utkarsh, makes silver H2O2, silver hydrogen peroxide. Time of planting. Tomato is a day-neutral plant, so widely it found grown in any season. In the north plains, there are three crops are taken, but where there is frost area is there, rabi crop is not very fruitful. The kharif crop is usually transplanted in July, rabi crop in October or November, and zaid crop in February month. In the southern plains, when there is no danger of frost, the first transplanting is done in December, January, second in during June, July, and third during September, October, depending on the irrigation facilities available. Seed rate. For nursery raising, normally for open pollinated variety, 120 to 160 grams per acre seeds are required. For hybrid variety, 50 to 70 grams per acre seed is required. Nursery bed preparation. The land is first of all plowed with soil turning plow, followed by 4 to 5 plowing with the country plow, so that soil becomes soft enough. The leveling should be done after plowing to bring the fine till soil and also provide better drainage facility. Tomato seeds are sown on nursery bed to raise seedlings for transplanting in the field. Raised bed are usually made of 3 meter width and 0.6 meter height and 3 meter length and 0.6 meter width, and the height is usually 10 to 15 centimeter. About 70 centimeter distance is kept between the two beds to carry out operations of watering, weeding, etc. The surface of the bed should be smooth and it should be well leveled. For good growing, add seed farmyard manure and fine sand on the seed bed. Raised beds are necessary to avoid problem of water logging, especially in the heavy soil. In sandy soil, however, sowing can be taken up in flat beds because there is no problem of water logging. To avoid mortality of seedling due to damping off, drench the seed bed first with water and then with carmidism 50%. The dosage is 15 to 20 grams per 10 liter of water. Or you can, if you are doing organic farming or prefer organic biological product, then go for Utkarsh Concrete, 2 ml per liter water. Raising of the seedling. If you are expert enough, then only we will prefer that you raise your seedling. But if any good nursery is available in your area, it is better to buy the desired variety or get your desired variety prepared from the expert nursery. But if you can raise the nursery yourself, then you should do it. Though prior to sowing, the seeds are treated usually with the fungal culture, that is Trichoderma vidi, which we have in the name of Trichospi, 4 grams per kg of seed, or for chemical treatment, carmidism, 2 grams per kg of seed to avoid damage due to damping of disease. Sowing should be done thinly in lines spaced at 10 to 15 centimeter distance. Seeds are usually sown at the depth of 2 to 3 centimeter, and then they are covered with a fine layer of soil, followed by light watering by water cane. The bed should be covered with a dry straw or grass or sugarcane leaves to maintain required temperature and moisture. The watering should be done by water can as per the need till the germination is completed. Overwatering or less watering should be always avoided. The cover of dry straw or grass is removed immediately after the germination is complete. During the last week in nursery, the seedlings may be hardened by slightly withholding water for 4 to 5 days. So reduce moisture up to 20%. Usually this will make very good healthy root, and stem formation will also take place. The seedling with 5 to 6 true leaves are ready for transplanting within 4 to 5 weeks of sowing. Land preparation. The field is plowed to fine tilth by giving 4 to 5 plowing with the sufficient interval between the two plowing. Planking should be done for proper leveling. Leveling is very much required. Then the furrows are then opened at the recommended spacing. Well-decomposed farmyard manure, that is 10 tons per acre, is thoroughly incorporated at the time of land preparation. This is must and this is required. This is the base of any farming. So farmyard manure should always be applied. Spacing. Spacing usually depends on the type of variety grown and the season of planting. Normally, the seedlings are transplanted at the space of 75 to 90 centimeter by 45 to 60 centimeter. This is the spacing between two rows and two seeds in the same row. Method of planting. The seedlings are usually transplanted in furrow for light soil on and on the side of ridges in case of heavy soil. Pre-soaking irrigation is usually given 3 to 4 days prior to transplanting. This is required because when it is done in summer, due to very high temperature of the soil, the seedling may die. So pre-soaking irrigation is the must. Before planting, seedling should be dipped in a solution prepared by Carmentism 15 grams and Mancozeb 25 grams in 10 liter water. Or if you want to do biological treatment, go for 2 ml Pumpree or 20 ml Pumpree in 10 liters water for 5 to 6 minutes. Transplanting should be preferably done in the evening because when there is high temperature, the shock will not happen. Intercultivation. For weed control, intercultivation is required, and also for air should go inside. The field should be kept weed-free, especially in the initial stage of the plant growth, as wheat usually compete with the crop and reduce the yield drastically. Frequent shallow cultivation should be done at regular interval so as to keep the field free from weeds and to facilitate soil aeration and proper root development. Very deep lowing should not be done because the roots of tomato are very much sensitive and very thin. Deep cultivation is injurious because it damages the roots and exposure of moist soil to the surface. 2 to 3 hoeing and then the earthing up are required to keep the crop free of weeds. Pre-emergence application of Vaseline, that is 400 grams per acre, or Pendimethalin 400 ml per acre, coupled with one hand weeding 45 days after transplanting is effective for control of weeds. So combination of weedicide as well as hand weeding should be done. Mulching is also a very good option to control the weeds. And usually 50 microns black phosphate is recommended, which usually controls up to 95% weeds. If you don't want to go for plastic and we want to go for organic mulch, you can use sugarcane trash, which usually controls about 60% of weeds. Crop rotation. It is a must. Tomato should not be grown successfully on the same field, and a break of at least 1 year is required between the planting of tomatoes or other solanaceous crop. Tomato also belongs to the solanaceous family. The other crops of this family are chili, brinjal, capsicum, potato, tobacco, and also cucurbitas and many other vegetables. So these are the families with which the tomato planting should be avoided. The crops which can be grown after tomato are cereal crops like rice, corn, sorghum, wheat, millet, etc. Or cruciferous crop like cabbage, cauliflower, kohlrabi, etc. Or roots crop like radish, watermelon, onion, garlic, groundnut, cotton, safflower, sunflower, sesame, sugar beet, and marigold. Intercropping. Tomato is usually well fitted with different cropping system of cereals, grains, pulses, oilseeds, etc. A cropping system like rice along with tomato, tomato along with rice, maize, or okra, potato, tomato and onion, they are very popular in different parts of our country. India. Spinach and radish can also be grown as intercrop and tomato successfully. Stacking facilitated intercultural operation and helps in maintaining the quality of the fruit. Since the veins are very much soft, so stacking is required. Otherwise, the tomato will be in the on the soil and good quality will not come. Usually, stacking is done 2 to 3 weeks after transplanting. Stacking can be done either by a wooden stick or laying overhead wire to which individual plant is tied. Usually, it is in local language, it is also called telephone padhati. This is the system of stacking which is supporting of the tomato plants. The long growing varieties of tomato need to be specially supported. At the time of plant growth, plant should be stacking with the help of string or wire. With the help of this support, fruits cannot expose to soil and water. Hence, there is no problem of tomato fruit rotting so that more production can be obtained. Pruning. This is also very important operation for good quality of tomato. It is usually done for intermediate tomato varieties. There are various severe advantages. First of all, pruning enables farmer to monitor and balance the vegetation and fruit set of plants. Furthermore, pruning facilitates aeration, due to which many kinds of infection are prevented. In order to grow properly, a common pruning technique includes removal of outer stem, leaving only, means only main stem is remaining, all the outer are removed so that the plant grows single veined and expand only vertically. Another technique is when the plant is of smaller size, the head of the plant is removed, due to which 2 to 4 peripheral branches come. So then 2 to 4 main branches are developed. Is it audible for others? Mr. Sushan is unable to. Please reply in the chat box. Sir, I can hear your voice.
Yeah, voice is audible, sir.
Is it audible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Sir, you can check at your end what is the condition. Mr. Surchanji. Now about irrigation. Tomato is very sensitive to water application. So heavy irrigation, which is provided after a very long spell of drought, it usually causes cracking of the fruit. So it should be avoided. Light irrigation should be given normally 3 to 4 days after transplanting. Irrigation interval should be according to soil type. If the soil is as well as rainfall, if the soil type is sandy, smaller interval should be there. And if it is heavy soil, longer interval can be done. Usually 7 to 8 days interval is done during kharif crop, during rabi crop 10 to 12 days, and during summer when the temperature is high, it is usually 5 to 6 days. Flowering and fruit setting are very critical stages of tomatoes. Therefore, water stress should not be given during this stage. Actually, water stress should not be given during any of the stage, but these are the very critical stages. Manuring and fertilization. The fertilizer dose usually depends on the fertility of soil and the amount of organic manure applied. But we will always prefer that minimum 6 to 8 tons up to 10 tons of well-decomposed farmyard manure should be incorporated into the soil per acre. As per university, application of 48 kg of nitrogen, 32 kg of P2O5, 20 kg of K2O per acre is recommended for getting the optimum yield. Usually of this half dose of nitrogen and full dose of phosphorus and potassium is usually given at the time of planting. The balance half of nitrogen is given as top dressing 30 days after transplanting. This is usually followed when the drip irrigation fertigation system is not there. For hybrid varieties, the recommended dose is per acre 72 kg nitrogen, 40 kg P2O5 and 24 kg K2O. Then 60 kg of nitrogen and half of PNK are usually given at the time of transplanting. Remaining quantity of PNK and 60 kg nitrogen is top dressed 30 days after transplanting. Third dose of 60 kg nitrogen is usually applied 50 days after transplanting. All both these of these are usually when the water is given without drip irrigation, flood irrigation. So these are the critical stages of the plant. So it depends on this fertilizer should be given. The usually leaf development stages from 0 to 15 days after transplanting. Flowering stage is considered 16 to 30 days after transplanting. Fruit setting stage is 31 to 41 days after transplanting. And fruit growth stage is 42 days to harvesting. During this period, the total fertilizer application in kg via fertigation includes during period 1 and 2, that is 29 days in total, they apply 6.4 kg of nitrogen, 1.6 kg of P2O5, 9.6 kg of K2O, 0.8 kg of calcium oxide, that is usually given in the form of calcium nitrate. During the third period, which is of 11 days, apply 2.4 kg of nitrogen, 0.8 kg of P2O5, 3.2 kg of K2O and 0.4 kg of CaO, calcium oxide. During the fourth stage, that is fruit growth stage, fertilization rate increases dramatically and farmers apply 8 kg of nitrogen, 2.4 kg of P2O5, 14 kg of K2O and 0.8 kg of calcium oxide. These quantities are total. They are not total daily amount. This is for the total period. They are counted in kilogram per acre. This is not the fertilizer. This is the actually the elemental quantity. So when we convert it into a schedule, we have also prepared a schedule based on this. So basal dose usually should give DAP 50 kg, MOP 25 kg and Marvel G, which is combination of humic, fulvic, amino seaweed along with biofertilizer, that is 10 kg. 5 days after transplanting for root formation, roots multiply, stress phase is given. Then the growth stage is there where 1919 urea is given. For excellent root development and controlling other disease, microbes and MOS is given. All these fertilizers are usually given through drip irrigation. 14 to 19 days, 1919 urea, 1919 urea. Then flowering and fruit staging stage, horsepower, which is polyphosphate, is given along with stress free. Then magnesium sulfate is required for photosynthesis from 32 to 36 days. 1261-0 for that is MAP and along with urea is given. 37 day F enhancer is given, which is combination of calcium, magnesium and boron. And flowering and fruiting stage is usually taken care of. And then from 51 to 54 days, 13-0, 40-0, I'll be sharing this schedule in our tomato group also. So along with this fertigation, some sprays are also given, like Primol and Stress Free are usually given initially for growth and development. Bio Clean Sweep is given to control various kinds of insects like caterpillar and sucking pest. 45th day, Panther and Marvel is given for flowering along with Double Combi and Viro so to avoid virus. All these are given as a preventive so that best yield can be taken. 60th day, 13-0-45 calcium nitrate is given for good fruit quality and size development along with Vidimune. So these are our different products that we recommend at the different stages. 30th day, 37th day, 42nd day. So some growth regulators are also recommended that you can use directly. Gibberellic acid is usually recommended 10 to 20 milligrams per liter as a foliar spray for high when the temperature is very low. If you want to go for seed treatment also, that can also be, gibberellic can be used for very good for seed germination of tomato seeds. Then Ethypon is also used 100 to 500 milligrams per foliar spray during the flowering fruiting stage. For pre-harvesting stage, usually Ethypon is used for ripening, so that can be pre-harvesting, it can be used. Another hormone, PCPA, is also recommended when the flowering is low flowering. Usually, this is given when the temperature is very high. Now, we'll see the various different insect damages that happens in the tomato crop. Insects and pest. The first one is fruit borer. Usually the symptoms are the young larva feed on the tender foliage. Mature larva usually bore the circular hole like this, as shown. only the part of the body is into the fruit and eat the inner content. In this way, the larva goes inside. To manage this, collect and destroy the infected fruits and grown-up larva. Simultaneously, you grow 40 days, up to 40 days, American tall marigold or and for 25 days old tomato seedling with one plant of marigold for every 16 plants of tomato seedling. Also set up a pheromone trap with helilure at 5 helilure per acre. Collection and whatever is collected, infected, they should be damaged. They should be destroyed. You can also spray Utkarshmiti, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, at 2 ml per liter water or any of the following chemical pesticide like azadirachtin, which is also 100% organic. At Utkarsh, we have four types of Nemos: Nemos Cold Press, Nemos Gold, Nemos Silver, and Nemos Basic. You can use any of them for chemical indoxocarb, flubendiamide, and novalocrone. So these are various insecticides recommended for control of larva along with the doses. Then there is hornworm. This is also a very common insect. Hornworms are a humongous green caterpillar that feed on the leaves in grave amounts, consuming large number of whole leaves. So whenever hornworms are there, they destroy the plant very fast. This level of depollution can be devastating to the plant, greatly reducing productivity and yield. More mature hornworms are known to feed on fruit. Then whitefly. Symptoms of whitefly: there are chlorotic spot, yellowing, downward curling, and drying of leaves. And it is the actual whitefly is the vector of tomato leaf curl virus disease. In order to control whitefly, you should use a yellow sticky trap for early attack detection. After transplanting, give a neem-based imidacloprid. This should be given after 15 days of planting, and it should not repeat because it is harmful during the fruit stage because it leaves the residues, and it is also not considered for good management practices. The other insecticide used to control whitefly are dimethoate, melathion, thymethoxan, oxydimethon methyl. Then aphids. Aphids usually populate new stem and the underside of leaves, leaving sticky honeydew in their wake. Aphids usually suck the nutrient-rich sap from the plant. The honeydew attracts other pesky insects also. When the aphid infestation is very heavy, it may cause leaves to become yellow and distorted. Necrotic spots are developed on the leaves, and the shoots become stunted. These are the various chemical insecticides used: carbosulfan, fipronil, imidacloprid, phosplane, quinol phos. These are used to control aphids. Then leaf miner, usually it is thin white winding trails on the leaves. Heavy mining can result on white blotches on leaves and leaf dropping from the plant prematurely. Usually when there is heavy attack of leaf miner, it reduces the photosynthesis activity of the plant. Early infestation can cause the fruit yield because the photosynthesis reduces as the leaf area becomes smaller. Adult leaf miner is a small black and yellow moth which lays its egg in the leaf. Larva hatch and feed on the leaf miner. Usually, the infected leaves are usually collected and destroyed. You can spray Nemos Gold 1 to 2 ml per liter water in order to control leaf miner organically. Thrips. When the population of thrips is very high and it usually distorts the birds, leaf appears silvery and they are speckled with black faces. And usually a thrip attack on the whenever in the young fruit or young leaves only. So it should be controlled initially only. And thrips usually they are the vector for the transmission of a tomato spotted wilt virus. Then spider mites, spider rat mites. The symptoms are leaves usually become stippled with yellow. Leaves may appear bronze. Webbing covering the leaves usually is visible. Mites may be visible as tiny moving dots on the web that is usually on the underside of the leaf. It is usually best viewed using a hand lens. Even when you rub your finger on the leaf infected with the red mite, stain of blood like things come on your finger, and you can easily even detect without using the lens also. Usually red mites are not spotted unless they are visible symptoms on the plant. Leaves turn yellow and may droop from the plant. In order to control, spray wettable sulfur or dicopol. You can also use Utkarsh BioClean Sweep 2 ml per liter water if you want to control it organically. This loopers. Loopers usually are, they make large or small holes in leaves. Their damage often is extensive. Looper caterpillars are pale green with white lines running down either side of their body. These are the lines which I am talking about, this line. The caterpillars are easily distinguished by the way they arch their body when moving. So they, in local language, it is also called a horse kind of caterpillar because it moves like a horse. Eggs are laid singly, usually on the lower leaf surface, close to the leaf margin, and they are white or pale green in color. Various insects, they are insecticide. They are the same as controlling any other caterpillar. The IPA package for tomato. Seed treatment should be done with the Sudocel at 10 grams per kg of seed. Nursery application with Utkarsh Tricozel and Utkarsh Sudocel. Neem cake should be applied at 250 kg per hectare, especially when in your area the nematodes problem is there. Good selection variety should be done, and the virus free seedling should be planted. In case up to 45 days there is any virus infected plant, it should be removed immediately. Grow marigold as a water crop. This will control whitefly and it will avoid the spreading of virus. Set up Helicoverpa or Spodoptera pheromone trap at 12 numbers or 5 numbers per acre or 12 numbers per hectare. Install a yellow sticky trap for controlling whitefly and aphids. Spray Utkarsh Nemos Gold formulation, that is 1% at 10,000 ppm, or neem seed kernel at straight 5%. Or you can spray Utkarsh BioClean Sweep at 2 ml per liter water to control various kinds of sucking pests and all kinds of larvae. So this is our Utkarsh Sudocel and Tricozel. This is BioClean Sweep, which is combination of Metarhizium, Anisopli, Beveria Bassiana, Verticillium Ricanae. This is 10,000 ppm neem oil. Nemos Gold. Root knot nematode. The characteristic symptom of root knot nematode is the presence of galls on the roots, which can be up to 3.3 cm, that is 1 inch in diameter, but they are usually smaller. Galls cause a reduction in plant vigor. If the galls on the roots are extensive, then plants may yellow and wilt, particularly in the hot weather. So in order to control organically, you can give Nematonil, which is combination of Pseudomyces, Trichoderma, Arzenium, and four other different kinds of fungus. And then now we'll look at the various disease that comes in tomato plant. First, we'll see the virus, different viruses, leaf curl. It is also called tomato leaf curl virus. Leaf curl symptoms include mosaic, intravenial yellowing, vein clearing and crinkling, and puckering, accompanied often more often by inward rolling of leaf margin. The older leaves become leathery and brittle. The disease includes severe stunting, bushy growth, and partial or complete sterility depending on the stage of the crop. Infected plants bear few or no fruits. Management is that keep a yellow sticky trap at 5 per acre to monitor whitefly because they spread it. Raise barrier crops like cereal around the field. Remove a weed host, protected nursery in net house or greenhouse. Spray imidacloprid to control the vectors or dimethoate every 15, 25, 45 days. Spray Utkarsh Virus Virimune alternatively as per our schedule, alternatively 3 to 4 ml per liter water. But when the infection is very heavy, it is very much difficult to control it. But once you see, you should start doing all this for all other plants. Then second one is the tomato mosaic virus. Mosaic symptoms appear on leaves as dark green islands surrounded by light green areas. Leaf size is usually reduced. The dark green areas of the mottle often appears thicker and somewhat elevated, giving the leaves a blister-like appearance. Leaves sometimes look like wand-like and sharply pointed. Early infection reduces fruit set and occasionally causes blemishes and distortion of the fruit. If in the initial stage tomato mosaic virus is seen, you can easily control by spraying virus Combi 2 and controlling the vector. But it is difficult to recover the plants which are have come to the advanced stage of leaf curl virus. So leaf curl virus plant should be completely removed whenever there is attack. Now we'll see the different fungal disease, different kinds of wilt. Fusarium wilt, lower leaves, usually the symptoms are lower leaves turn yellow. Yellowing often begins on one side of the plant and progresses upward. Infected leaves curl downward, following by browning and drying. Vascular browning is evident in stems and leaf petioles. Young plants, when infected, they are severely stunted. These are the symptoms. Yellowing of lower leaves and their wilting is on the upper side. And this severe wilting, the entire plant becomes dried. Then Ralstonia wilt. Wilting occurs among plants in patches. Wilting of terminal leaves followed by sudden and permanent wilting of whole plants are seen in 2 to 3 days. The adventitious roots develop on the main stem and vascular bundle turns brown, the adventitious root. Bacteria oozes from the freshly cut stem when placed in water. In this way, it is usually tested. The freshly cut stem is placed in water and bacteria oozes off. Recently wilted plants are green, which distinguishes from the fusarium wilt, wherein plants develop yellowing of leaves. The discoloration of the pith also distinguishes bacterial wilt from fusarium. Then third kind of wilt is Sclerotium wilt. The brown lesions are seen on the stem just above the soil surface or at the foot of the plant. Brown lesions later become covered with white radiating mycelium that encircles the affected portion. So these are the different kinds of mycelium, white mycelium, which is being developed. So we can confirm that this is Sclerotium wilt. Subsequently, the mustard-sized sclerotia appears on the infected area as the disease develops and spreads. Distinct rot occurs beneath the fungal web, leading to wilt-like symptoms characterized by yellowing and browning of the foliage. Foot rot symptoms are recognized when young plants are completely griddled and they are killed. Then bird blight, groundnut. It is also called groundnut bird necrosis virus. The characteristic symptoms on leaves include yellowing, chlorotic and necrotic ring spot and tip necrosis. Presence of longitudinal brown necrotic streak is conspicuous on the petioles, stem and fruit stalk. Chlorotic ring spot are often observed on the plant. See, this is chlorotic. The chlorosis, the yellowing happens at patches. So the ring spot virus, it can be called. Fruit set is marked reducedly. Dieback and stunted plant growth are common symptoms. So in this way, we can identify these kinds of necrotic spots appears on leaves. The tips are also necrosis is there. Early blight. The lower leaves are more susceptible than the upper ones in case of early blight. Similarly, disease is more serious in older than the younger plants. Smaller, dark, circular lesions develop on leaves, which later turn distinctly zonate with conidia forming at the necrosis region. So these are the symptoms of early blight. These are the symptoms, lower leaves. Under severe attack, spot rapidly enlarges and coalesces and turn into complete blight, resulting in death of the leaves. Late blight. Late blight appears on the leaves, stems, and fruits. On the leaves, symptom appears as pale green, water-soaked spots, often begins at the leaf edge or leaf tip or on the edge. These lesions are often surrounded by a pale yellowish color border which merges with healthy tissue. Under favorable conditions, lesions enlarge rapidly and turn dark brown to pearlish black, killing the leaf instantly. So in this way, the lesions develop, they become bigger size, and then they kill the leaves instantly. Powdery mildew. Powdery mildew appears as small powdery white colonies on the upper leaf surface. The Oidiposis torica causes yellow blotches or spots on the upper leaf surface with white powdery growth occurring on the under surface. Severely affected leaves turn yellow, brown, then little brown and become shriveled. Generally, the lower leaves are affected first and then gradually moves up. Usually, powdery mildew is seen during the monsoon period as well as during the heavy winter. So, if the common symptoms are someone has sprayed talcum powder on the leaf. Septoria leaf spot. Septoria leaf spot occurs at any stage on the crop with first infection appearing on the older leaves. Numerous small circular water soaked spots appear on the undersurface of the lower leaves. So these types of spot appears. These spot develop dark brown margin with sunken white or gray centers containing numerous black spotted pycnidia. Severe spotting results in extensive leaf drying and wilting. Bacterial spot. All above ground plants are affected, especially leaves, stem, petiole, and fruit producing various symptoms. Symptoms appear on the leaves as small, discrete, light brown to dark brown, water-soaked lesions of less than 2 mm diameter. So these are the symptoms of bacterial spots. These are the lesions which are developed. Lesser than 2 mm in diameter. Lesions turn black, often surrounded by a yellow halo, which later disappears when lesions coalesces. Infected leaves become chlorotic, exhibit epinesti, and finally dry out. For controlling various diseases, usually these fungicides are recommended. Carbinism plus mencozeb, metalixil plus mencozeb, that is Ridomil, Dinocap, propiconazole, that is usually called Tilt, wettable sulfur, or if you want to control them organically, you can spray Fungpre, or you can also give Fungpre 1 liter per acre. So this is Fungpre, which is a combination of Trichoderma viridii, Trichoderma herzenium, and 4 other different kinds of fungus for controlling. It is a broad spectrum, completely 100% organic and biological fungicide. Now we'll see the nutrients required and their deficiency. Primary nutrient required are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, major nitrogen, phosphorus, potash, secondary calcium, magnesium, sulfur, micronutrient, iron, zinc, boron, manganese, copper, all are required. And other important nutrients required are silicon, cobalt, and aluminium. Now we'll see the different deficiencies. Severe nitrogen deficiency. In the symptoms, the affected plants are smaller in size and grow less vigorously than healthy plants. Symptoms appear on low older leaves first. Leaves, tomato leaves exhibit a general yellowing, occasionally accompanied by purple leaf veins. Plant possesses thinner stems and fruit is become smaller than healthy fruit. Healthy plant fruits may misshapen with a light red color than healthy plants. Various 3 types of nitrogenous fertilizer are available. Amide is the urea and urea phosphate. Ammonical is ammonium sulfate, ammonia nitrate, diammonium phosphate, and monoammonium phosphate. Nitrate fertilizer for nitrogen are potassium nitrate, calcium nitrate, ammonium nitrate, magnesium nitrate. The ones shown in bold are we make, we import, we pack, and we supply. Phosphorus deficiency. And in that deficiency, the growth of tomato seedling is reduced compared with healthy plant. Leaves appear darker green and may have purple tint. These are usually happens in lower leaves, older tomato plant leaves. Leaves grow upright and appear light green on the upper surface and purple on the lower surface. Symptoms appear on older leaves first. So the lower leaves become purple in color. That is the first symptom of phosphorus deficiency. To overcome there, you need to give SSP or DAP initially or TSP initially If you're a water soluble fertilizer, you can give mono ammonium phosphate or mono potassium phosphate. If you want to give nitrogen also, then give urea phosphate. And we have or you can give a polyphosphate, which we make in the name of horsepower, which contains three types of phosphorus. Potassium deficiency, the symptoms are affected plants are usually smaller than healthy plants with smaller fruits and reduce. Tomato leaves become browning, older, usually the edges of the leaf, the margin turns start turning tan and then brown at the margin. Deficiency is prolonged, leaves become necrotic at the margin and then turn yellow between the leaf veins. The deficiency of potassium is usually overcome by muriate of potash or sulfate of potash, potassium nitrate, monopotassium phosphate. Potassium is also available in NPK formulations like 1919, 13, 40, 13, 15, 15, 20, 10, 10, etc. So we have three kinds of this fertilizers. It is called 0050, 13045, 050, 234. Magnesium deficiency. Symptoms of magnesium deficiency appear on older leaves first. Initial symptoms are intravenous chlorosis of the leaf and occasionally a purple tinge on the leaf. As the deficiency becomes more severe, leaves may appear white with the green veins. The veins are green, but the remaining part has becoming yellow. Severe deficiency may lead to reduced fruit yield. Various fertilizers to overcome is magnesium sulfate. This is magnesium sulfate. This is magnesium nitrate and magnesium EDTA, which is we call it Magreen. That is for spraying. All three can be sprayed as well as can given to drip irrigation. Sulfur deficiency. The petiole usually shows a distinct reddish color. The petioles has become reddish color. The yellowing is much more uniform over the entire plant, including the young leaves. Entire plant becomes yellow. The reddish color often found on underside of the leaves. With advanced sulfur deficiency, the leaves tend to become more erect and often twisted and brittle. Various sulfur fertilizers are bentonite sulfur. This is bentonite sulfur, liquid lime sulfur, calcium polyphosphate. This is liquid calcium polyphosphate, sulfur 90% WDG. Also, various kinds of fertilizer can be given along with ammonium sulfate, potassium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, zinc sulfate, copper sulfate, ferrosulfate, etc. Calcium deficiency. The symptoms of calcium deficiency include blossom and rot of tomato. Very common disease. It is not a disease. It is a calcium deficiency. But many people don't know that this is actually calcium deficiency, but they consider it as a fungal disease. Symptoms show soft, dead, necrotic tissue at rapidly growing areas, which is generally related to poor translocation of calcium to the tissues rather than a low external supply of calcium. This ultimately results in the margin of the leaf growing more slowly than the rest of the leaf, causing the leaf to curve downward. Plants under chronic calcium deficiency have a much greater tendency to wilt than non-stress plants. Various calcium fertilizers are calcium nitrate, calcium EDTA, calcium boron, which contains 6% calcium and 5.5% boron, F enhancer that contains calcium, magnesium and boron in EDTA form. Zinc deficiency. Zinc deficiency, the younger leaves become yellow and pitting develops in the intravenial upper surface of the mature leaves. As the deficiency progresses, these symptoms develop into an intense intravenial necrosis, but the main veins remain yellow. You can see here, all the main veins are yellow, but the necrosis develops at spots, as in the symptoms of recovery of iron deficiency. So you can give zinc sulfate, it comes in 20% and 33%, or you can give Utkarsh zinc gap, which contains zinc EDTA 12% by spraying. Iron deficiency. Symptoms of iron deficiency starts out as intravenial chlorosis of the youngest leaves, evolving into overall chlorosis and ends as a totally bleached leaf. The entire leaf will become yellow like bleach has been given. Because iron has low mobility, iron deficiency appears first on the youngest leaf. To overcome the iron deficiency, you can use ferrosulfate or you can give FeEDTA 12%, which can be given by spraying. If the soil pH is above 7.5, you can give FeAdha, which we call FeDrip, which is 6%. You can give by drip or by drenching for the pH between 4 to 10. If your soil is acidic, give by spraying Epi DTPA, which contains 11% Epi. This is we have in the form of we sell the brand name in the name of Epi Aquarium. Boron deficiency. Necrosis of meristemic issues in the growing region, leading to loss of apical dominance and the development of rosette condition. These deficiency symptoms are similar to those caused by calcium deficiency. Actually, it is very much difficult sometimes to identify whether it is boron or calcium deficiency. And the cracking of food also takes place, even though there is no water deficiency. So, whenever it happens, both calcium as well as boron should be applied together. For that, we have made calciboron, which contains 6% calcium and 5.5% boron. Or borax is there, which is not water soluble. Then disodium octaborate that we have in the name of B-shape. Then F enhancer that contains calcium, magnesium and boron in EDDA form. Copper deficiency. It is usually very much less, but to overcome, you can use copper EDD or copper sulfate. Manganese deficiency, it is also very lessly seen. And to overcome that, you can use manganese sulfate or manganese EDD. Now, harvesting. This is very tricky. The right time harvesting should be done. There are six stages, different stages of fruit. These are the stages where green stage, breaker stage, turning stage, pink stage, light red stage and red stage. The description I will tell you. In a dark green color stage, the dark green color is changed and a reddish pink shade is observed on the fruit. Fruit to be shipped are harvested at this stage. Such fruits are then sprayed with ethylene 48 hours prior to shipping. Immature green tomatoes will ripen poorly and will be of low quality. A simple way to determine maturity is to slice the tomato with a sharp knife. If seeds are cut, the fruit is too immature for the harvest and will not ripen properly. So the right stage should be there. Then breaker stage. Dim pink color observed on 1/4 part of the fruit. Fruits are harvested at this stage to ensure best quality. Such fruits are less prone to damage during shipment, often fetch a higher price than less mature tomatoes. So this is the breaker stage, the harvesting stage, pink stage. Pink color observed on 3/4 part of the fruit, reddish pink stage. Fruits are stiff and nearly whole fruit turned reddish pink. Fruits for local sale are harvested at this stage. They do not have very good shelf life. Fully ripe fruits are fully ripe and soft, having dark color, dark red color. Such fruits are used for food processing industry for making ketchup and tomato puree. Fruits are normally harvested early in the morning or evening. The fruits are harvested by twisting motion, means like this, to separate the fruit from the stem. Harvested fruits should be kept only in basket or crates and kept in a shade. Since all fruits do not mature at the same time, they are harvested at an interval of 4 days. Generally, there will be 7 to 11 harvests in a crop lifespan. This is again for the indeterminate variety. So this is the breaker stage. This is the exact right stage to the right stage for harvesting the best quality of tomatoes that are to be transported. Usually the yield is 8 to 10 tons for OP varieties, and for hybrid varieties it is 20 to 24 tons per acre. I have shown you many of our products at Utkarsh. Our products are available from our website www.utkarshagro.com. They are also available on Amazon, Flipkart. Our company is listed on Trade India, Just Dial, India Mart, and our products are available on Moglix, AgriBagri, Big Heart, Agroshia, and we are also CII, member of CII, BINI, South Gujarat Chamber of Commerce. So various products that our company makes is various different kinds of biofertilizer, all kinds of nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, zinc, sulfur, solubilizing bacteria. We also have paddy microbes, various biopesticides like Bacillus subtilis, Metarhizium, Trichoderma, Herzenium, Utkarsh BT, Pacillomyces, Trichoderma viridi, Pseudomonas, Beveria bassiana, Vertens blicani, Metarhizium, combination microbes, which is combination of protective and nutritive, then Bioclinsweep, Nematonil, Nemofungo, then various EDTH related fertilizers like calcium EDTA, magnesium EDTA, iron EDTA, zinc EDTA, copper EDTA, manganese EDTA, a combi 2 and double combi, which are combination of all these. Then we have different miscellaneous fertilizers. And then we have got a complete range for aquarium plants, amino chelated fertilizers, spreaders, two kinds of non-ionic spreader, silicon-based spreader. Water-soluble, we have complete range. Media for and fertilizer for hydroponics. Then organic fertilizer also we have. Natural plant protector, neem oil, shield, strips, or mitos, viros, virimune. Then we have got leudes, then Utkarsh, silver H2O2. Then we have got PGR-based product like Uminos, Aminos, Zymos, Beam Plus, Fem Gold, liquid bioactive humic acid, Panther, Roots Multiplier. Now, if you have any question, you can write in chat box or you can ask directly. So I am through from my side. Mr. Nagaraj, Mr. Surchand, if you are having any query, any question, please ask. So my mobile number is this 9824133044. You can also send your photographs of your plants. And if you are not part of our Tomato or other WhatsApp group, you can ping me. I will send you a link to become a part of those groups. So if you are not having any question, we will complete our webinar at this point. Thank you very much for being on the webinar. This webinar will be available on YouTube within 2 to 3 days.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thanks for being part of this webinar.